everlasting mercy, who in the very recurrence of the Paschal feast, kindle the faith of the people you have made your own. Increase, we pray, the grace you have bestowed, that all may grasp and rightly understand in what fount they have been washed, by whose spirit they have been reborn, by whose blood they have been redeemed. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book from the Acts of the Apostles. They devoted themselves to the teaching of the apostles and to the communal life, to the breaking of bread and to the prayers. All came upon everyone, and many wonders and signs were done through the apostles. All who believed were together and had all things in common. They would sell their property and possessions and divide them among all according to each one's need. Every day they devoted themselves to meeting together in the temple area and to breaking bread in their homes. They ate their meals with exultation and sincerity of heart, praising God and enjoying favor with all the people. And every day the Lord added to their number those who were being saved. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Salvation that is ready to be revealed in the final time. In this you rejoice, although now for a little while you may have to suffer through various trials, so that the genuineness of your faith, more precious than gold that is perishable even though tested by fire, may prove to be for praise, glory, and honor at the revelation of Jesus Christ. Although you have not seen him, you love him. Even though you do not see him now, yet believe in him. You rejoice with an indescribable and glorious joy as you attain the goal of your faith, the salvation of your souls, the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
When the risen Lord appeared to the apostles on that first Easter night, The first thing he said to them when he saw them, "Peace be with you." In fact, three times our Lord addressed his disciples with that greeting, "Peace be with you." It is a way of promising life and mission and reconciliation and joy. It is what they needed to hear at that moment in their life. Peace be with you. But after our Lord's horrible death on Friday, the disciples knew that they would never see the Lord again. They feared for their own lives. When were they coming now after them? How were they to die? Who would betray them and hand them over to the authorities? The 3 years of their life spent knowing and hoping that Jesus was the Messiah, only to see him crucified in humility, in humiliation, killed as a common criminal. What happened to all that hope and all that joy and all that moments of thinking this was it? Thousands of years of waiting for the Messiah. Here he is. And how blessed we are by God to be in his inner court. Only to see and to see it all smashed away. And now what about us? What's going to happen to us? For our Lord's greeting of peace was certainly at odds with all the worries and all the troubles in our life. As our own worries and troubles press in around us, it's understandable why we might too question, like the apostles, can we believe in the Lord's greeting of peace? Is there really hope for us in that promise of the Lord's peace? For certainly many people who criticize religion say that faith is only a denial or at best an illusion of what's happening in the world today. Faith is a way of pretending that things will be okay if everybody hangs in there together. Everything will be fine. When in reality, we're just fooling ourselves. There's a cynicism that develops when things go bad for a while. So from this perspective, our Lord's greeting of peace can be seen as just a bunch of frilly, empty words. But there are much more than just words in the gospel today. For immediately after our Lord greets his disciples in peace, he follows those words with an action. He says, "Peace be with you." And then he shows them his hands and his side. There's not even a breath of space between the greeting and the scars. For our Lord unites his peace, the scars and wounds that he bears. He does this to show us that woundedness is not to be hidden. Being wounded, we can't pretend it doesn't exist or pretend that our scars don't hurt. For the peace of Christ is not a naive peace that seeks to make everything okay. But if it were, when our Lord rose from the dead, he would have ended all pain and all suffering. But when we share our wounds, show our scars, it leads to compassion. It leads to understanding. It leads to peace. For our Lord is telling us that in our relationship of friendship and love, we can sometimes serve our brothers and sisters not only with our strength, but even in our weakness. When someone we care about is worried or fearful or in pain, Our immediate response is to fix the problem right away. But as we know, in so many circumstances, we're not that powerful. We can't fix that problem. We cannot always take away the pain that our loved ones suffer. And how often we hear that coming from good and loving parents, or a spouse, or a friend, how they wish somehow they could take the pain of their loved one and bring it onto themselves. All of us are wounded. All of us carry scars. And the risen Christ bears those scars of his passion. Even when he ascends to heaven, even now, as he reigns in glory, those scars are still there. And he uses those wounds, those scars, to bring St. Thomas to faith. He brings those scars, those wounds, to bring the other disciples to joy. He does that for us as well. We should never be ashamed of sharing our scars with those whom we love. For in doing so, we see in the truth and the honesty of our own weakness someone who stands with us, one who has shared in weakness and suffering and pain and death. But that, of course, never was the final answer. There's always new life. And so our Lord reaches out to us today on this Divine Mercy Sunday to show forth his scars, to show forth his wounds, to show us his divine mercy, and to say to you and all your loved ones and all our children who are worried and scared, peace. Peace be with you. And give that peace as you reminded those disciples at the last time. I give you peace not as the world gives peace. Do not let your hearts be troubled. Have faith in God. Have faith in me. And in this Easter season, we profess the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell, and on the third day he rose again from the dead as he ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. And so on this most joyous day of the year, we turn to our gracious Father and ask him to hear our prayers.
For the renewal of our Catholic faith, a greater love and appreciation for the sacraments of the Church, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Our country and the countries of the world, may we live in peace and tranquility, turning to God in our need, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick and suffering, particularly those suffering from the coronavirus, may their sufferings be eased by the knowledge of our prayers, love and support, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the families of the dying, may be consoled by our prayers, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
The doctors, nurses, and all our healthcare workers, may they see the face of Christ in their patients as we thank you, God, for their dedication and their sacrifices. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Our beloved dead and all who have died, especially those who have died without family or friends around them, for their grieving families, may the light of Christ conquering over death be their support and strength. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
The silence of our hearts will present to God our particular intentions.
Lord, hear our prayer.
O good and gracious Father, we turn to you at this moment in time to plead to you to end this pandemic, to spare our loved ones and us from this sickness. Help those who are afflicted, their families who must see them from afar, and those who help and care for them. May our Blessed Mother, the health of the sick, Saint Joseph, the protector of your church, intercede for us now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Church, Be pleased to grant her peace, to guard, unite, and govern her throughout the whole world, together with your servant, Francis, our Pope, Timothy, our Bishop, and all those who hold to the truth, and on the Catholic and Apostolic faith.
Remember, Lord, your servants, and all gathered here, whose faith and devotion are known to you. For them we offer you the sacrifice of praise, or the offer for themselves, and all who are dear to them, for the redemption of their souls, in hope of health and well-being, and paying their homage to you, the eternal God, living and true. Celebrating the most sacred day, for the resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ in the flesh, and in communion with those whose memory we venerate, especially the glorious ever Virgin Mary, Mother of our God and Lord Jesus Christ, and Blessed Saint Joseph, her spouse, your blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter and Paul, Andrew, James, John, Thomas, James, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Simon and Jude, Linus, Cletus, Clemens, Sextus, Cornelius, Cyprian, Lawrence, Chrysostomus, John and Paul, Cosmas and Damian, and all your saints. We ask that through their merits and prayers, in all things, you may be defended by your protecting help.
Therefore, O Lord, we pray, graciously accept this oblation of our service and that of your whole family. Order our days in your peace, and command that we be delivered from eternal damnation and count among the flock of those you have chosen. Be pleased, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve his offering in every respect, make it spiritual and acceptable, so that it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. For on his day before he was to suffer, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands. With eyes raised to heaven, to you, O God, his almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands, and once more giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The history of faith. Sacrifice of Abraham, our father in faith, and the the offerings of your high priest Melchizedek, a holy sacrifice, a spotless victim. In humble prayer, we ask you, Almighty God, command that these gifts be borne by the hands of your holy angel to your altar on high in the sight of your divine majesty, that through our participation at this altar receive the most holy body and blood of your Son, we may be filled with every grace and heavenly blessing through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Remember also, Lord, your servants, who have gone before us in the sign of faith and rest in the sleep of peace. Grant them, O Lord, we pray, and all who sleep in Christ, a place of refreshment, light, and peace. Cross also your servants, who those sinners, hoping your abundant mercies, graciously grant some share and fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, Ignatius, Alexander, Marcellinus, Peter, Felicity, Perpetual, Agatha, Lucy, Agnes, Cecilia, Anastasia, and all your saints. Admit us, we beseech you, into their company, not weighing our merits, but granting us your pardon, through Christ our Lord, for whom we continue to make all these good things. O Lord, who sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, and restore them.
Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Oh.
gaps of spiritual communion. By Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most blessed sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I am unable at this moment to receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you are already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. As you go out for your daily walks, I encourage you to stop by church. Our church is open every day from 8 until 7 at night, so stop by, make a visit to our Lord in the Blessed Sacrament, and offer up your prayers for your family and your friends. As the time goes on, a lot of patience of people wearing thin, so hang in there, be strong in your faith, be strong in your love for one another, and if you need to take a time break to get away from one another, that's a good thing too. And it's okay to feel sad. It's a very sad, sad moment. There's nothing wrong with
feeling sad, but we can't fall into despair. We can't fall into hopelessness. The Lord is with us. He's giving us that strength and purpose. And one day we'll look back at this and see what it all kind of happened. But in the meantime, stay strong. Ask God to protect you and your family, your loved ones. Stay safe, and we pray for one another. And we pray for our parishioners and our those in town, those in hospitals and suffering in every way. So God bless you. We look forward to being with you today at 3, and if not, certainly next Sunday as well. The Lord be with you. And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Go forth in peace. The Mass is ended. Alleluia. Alleluia.
Thanks be to God.
Alleluia. Alleluia.